Have you ever thought about what is going on inside a black hole? How powerful black holes are? We know that even light cannot escape their depths, but a black hole pulling six galaxies at once is truly incredible. Suppose black holes contain entire universes. What if we happen to be residing in one of those universes? However, we know so little about black holes that even this may be the tip of the iceberg. One black hole monster is 1,000 times larger than the Sun has managed to achieve this, spreading a web 300 times larger than the Milky Way. As you reach any black hole monster, the gravitational field develops greatly, and as it increases, time slows down more and more. At least because human life is not sufficient to make this conceivable. Even if we could somehow speed up this process, we would still be unable to penetrate a black hole. So what exactly happens at the center of a black hole? The singularity at the core of a black hole is the ultimate no land. Man's location where matter is compressed to an infinitely small point, and all concepts of time and space are entirely destroyed. It also does not exist. Something must replace the singularity, but we don't know what. It's possible that matter isn't compressed down to an indefinitely small point deep inside a black hole. Instead, the smallest possible structure of matter, the smallest possible pocket of volume, may exist. A Planck star is a theoretical possibility imagined by loop quantum gravity, which is itself a very speculative concept for producing a quantum form of gravity. Space and time are quantized in the realm of loop quantum gravity. The universe around us is made up of tiny distinct chunks, yet at such an extraordinarily small scale that our movements appear smooth and continuous. The idea that space-time is made up of chunks is good in two ways. One, it brings quantum mechanics' dream to its logical conclusion by describing gravity in a natural way. Second, it prevents singularities from forming inside black holes. Matter encounters resistance as it squishes down beneath the massive gravity mass of a collapsing star. The concreteness of space-time prevents matter from traveling any further than the Planck length, about 1.68 times 10 to 35 meters. Everything that has ever fallen into a black hole is compacted into a ball no larger than this, perfectly minuscule but not infinitely small. Because of this resistance to further compression, the material eventually uncollapses, i.e. explodes, rendering black holes just transitory things. However, due to the enormous time dilation effects near black holes, it takes billions, if not trillions, of years for them to go boom from our viewpoint in the outside universe. So we're all set for the time being. The Gravistar is another approach to eliminating the singularity that does not rely on untested quantum gravity ideas. My spell checker didn't even detect the word because it's such a speculative idea. The Gravistar differs from a black hole in that it is filled with dark energy rather than a singularity. Dark energy is a material that pervades space-time and causes it to expand. It seems like science fiction, but it's true. Dark energy is currently at work in the broader cosmos, accelerating the expansion of our universe. When matter falls upon a gravistar, it is unable to penetrate the event horizon because of all of the dark energy on the interior, and hence remains on the surface. Gravistars, on the other hand, seem and behave like ordinary black holes. The event horizon of a black hole is its point of no return, the limit beyond however nothing, not even light, can escape. However, due to the fact that merging gravistars will produce a different signal than merging black holes, current gravitational wave observations of black hole mergers have the potential to rule out the existence of gravistars. Organizations like LIGO, the Laser Interferometer Gravitational Wave Observatory, and Virgo are finding more and more cases of these mergers every day. While gravistars aren't precisely forbidden in our realm, they are obviously on shaky ground. Planck stars and gravistars have fantastic names, but their presence is in doubt. Perhaps a more commonplace explanation for singularities exists, one based on a more nuanced and realistic picture of black holes in our universe. The concept of a single point of infinite density is derived from our understanding of motionless, non-rotating, uncharged, very uninteresting black holes. Real black holes have far more interesting personalities, especially when they spin. A revolving black hole spin expands the singularity into a ring, and according to Einstein's theory of general relativity, the only math we have, once you pass through the ring singularity, you enter a wormhole and emerge via a white hole, the opposite of a black hole where nothing can enter and matter rushes out at the speed of light, onto a totally new and interesting area of the universe. One of the problems is that the interiors of rotating black holes are extremely susceptible to instability. And all of this is founded on the same mathematics that underpins the theory that we will one day be able to travel to another universe. The problem with black holes that spin is that they rotate, as their name suggests. The singularity has been expanded into a ring, and due to the breakneck speed at which it is rotating, it generates a massive amount of centrifugal force. Large centrifugal forces behave similarly to anti-gravity in general relativity, in that they exert a pushing force rather than a pulling force. As a direct consequence of this, an inner horizon will develop within the black hole. Radiation from outside this zone is sliding inwards towards the singularity, accelerated by the strong gravitational force. On the other hand, radiation is propelled around the ring singularity by anti-gravity, and the inner horizon acts as a tipping point for the radiation. If you arrived over the inner horizon, you would be confronted with a wall of infinitely energetic radiation. It would be like having the whole history of the universe blasted into your face in the span of a single blink of an eye. The formation of the inner horizon seeds the death of a black hole. However, there are examples of revolving black holes in our universe, which suggests that our mathematical understanding is flawed and that something unusual is taking place. Imagine if a desperate researcher decided to embark on such a quest. The first step would be to traverse the accretion disk surrounding the black hole. Faster than the speed of light, this brilliant gas area rotates. The friction of the matter that gets sucked into the black hole also makes it very hot, so the researcher would be instantly burned to death. Although one theory claims that black hole accretion disks are cooled by quantum noise, this is not the case. Accordingly, it's safe to assume that the researcher won't suffer any physical harm while traversing this location. A little black hole, on the other hand, would not have allowed him to survive due to the intense gravity. However, experts claim that gravity is weaker in massive black holes, and if this is the case, the researcher may have glimpsed a universe within a black hole. Because of the immense gravitational pull of such enormous celestial objects, matter and even light cannot leave them for an extended period of time. For a long time, scientists assume that black holes contain nothing but dust, the remnants of stars, planets, and galaxies that had yet to be devoured by these monsters. However, cosmologists have discovered that revolving black holes are not as simple as previously thought. It is possible that big celestial bodies, like planets, could rotate in their wombs when specific circumstances are met, including photons and other particles. Space within a superconducting black hole is being stretched and twisted, according to physicists. Like the expanding cosmos, this occurs at various rates and in all directions. However, this isn't the only similarity. What exactly is going on inside a black hole? We don't know, and the frightening aspect is that we might never know. Then that's for today's video. We sincerely hope you enjoyed the video. If so, give it a like and share it with your friends and family. Let us know if you have any questions or comments in the section below. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel to see more of our incredible videos. You can also watch our other videos that have been specially selected for you. Look forward to seeing you in the next video.